Out came out talking about Harlem World, Pit of Harlem. What does Harlem mean to Mase?
All right, I want to get back to what you were saying about all those boroughs that represent. A lot of people was from Harlem, but they was ashamed to say they was from Harlem because there wasn't nobody basically saying I'm from Harlem and Harlem is a town. So that's what I wanted to do. When I said Harlem, I wanted everybody to feel happy to say they from Harlem, you know, and not say they from Uptown, because Uptown is basically Mount Vernon in the Bronx. That's not Uptown. Harlem is not Uptown.
So why does everybody think that Harlem is such a negative area? You know, folks that move from out of town are like nervous coming up here. Oh, can't go to Harlem. Oh, can't go to Harlem.
No, Harlem is not the bad spot. It's the people who come here that's not from here that mess it up.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody from Harlem just want to get money, and they just want the good life. That's okay. All Harlem is about. Harlem is about making money. That's why they call it money making.
Did you think as a little boy at home that you'd be having the good life at your, you know, fingertips?
I don't know. Basically, I grew up with him, Cam, and Dre right there, and we all went to this school together. We all knew one of us was gonna be successful, but we didn't know which one was gonna be successful, but we basically stayed together. And now I'm the first one. He gonna rap and he gonna model, so we got our plan together.
Okay, thug models walking the catwalk. They look good, y'all, too. Okay, Rap City don't go nowhere. It's all about Mase, Harlem World. I'm just a squirrel trying to get a nut in his world. You know what I'm saying?
Double up. It's not a game.
What's the name of this school? Manhattan Center for Science and Mathematics?
Manhattan Center for Science and Mathematics.
Okay.
Alumni.
So don't just think that he just rolled up on his set. The man got brains, too.
Yeah, we went to intelligence school.
Hey, act like you know. So now tell everybody how you met Puff Daddy.
I was actually going to Atlanta to meet Jermaine Dupri down in So-So Def. I wanted to be down with So-So Def.
Mm-hmm.
But on my way down there, I got a chance to meet Puff, and we just clicked from the start. It wasn't like no hassle or anything.
What was it about So-So Def that just made you like hop on a plane and be like, yo, Jermaine, you need to put me on?
Nah, because Jermaine had heard me through another guy, and I was just going down there on my own. He didn't tell me to come down there. I just knew I had something that the world needed to hear.
Mm-hmm. So before you got to the office, you and Puffy kind of hooked up.
Yeah.
How approachable was Puffy? Because you know everybody's always in his face 30 seconds
nah,
out of
it. Nah, it was unusual, like, incident, because he came up to me and said, Shorty, why you wearing my outfit? And I was like, I ain't wearing your outfit. So, you know, at that time, I ain't really know Puff, so I ain't take that a good way.
Okay.
But then he was like, what you doing down here? I said I was going to get a deal. And he said, what you do? I said, I rap. He said, you don't want to rap for me? I said, I rap.
That sound like Puffy, too. What about me?
So I rapped for him, and he said, don't talk to nobody else. You're going to be a bad boy.
And did you believe him, or did he, like, prove it right then and there? Or, like, a week later, he gave you a phone call, sent you some contracts? What happened?
Nah, when I came back home, I had a BMW. I went and got all my friends, said, yo,
no, you
I got
didn't.
The car.
Yeah, no, you didn't.
Right.
No, you didn't. It was not sitting in front of your house with a bow on it.
Nah, with the bow, but with the keys. That's all that matters.
Get out of here. Dang. Say it isn't so. See what I'm saying? Dreams do come true, y'all.
No
the
doubt.
The girl Les hanging out with Mase, Cam, Tony, and the rest of the crew in the
Big
back.
Dre.
Okay?
Bad Boy Entertainment.
Harlem World. We're going to take y'all all over the place.
Double up. Double up.
What happened to all the contracts and the paperwork and handling the business aspect? The car thing is cute and all, but I'm saying.
All right, once he bought the car, I knew he was serious. So from there, I began to negotiate, get my own lawyer, and create my own identity, because I didn't want to take things that was appointed to me.
Right. How hard was it for you to step aside and be like, this is who I'm going to be, even though I'm down with Bad Boy?
It wasn't that hard, because I felt like I was the guy that could really take Bad Boy to another level, like acting-wise and just overall character. Not sounding cocky or anything, just
right.
A different type of talent.
Okay, but now you two are kind of deemed as a dynamic duo, you know what I'm saying? Whereas you're Robin, he's Batman.
Yeah.
Is that helping your career or is that hurting your career?
I got to rephrase it from Batman and Robin to J. Jordan and Scottie Pippen.
Hey, hey, hey.
Because see, with Robin, you only accept Robin when he with Batman.
Okay.
So Scottie would still be Scottie if he wasn't with Michael Jordan.
There you go.
But he's great with Michael Jordan.
Okay. Now, how much is Mase doing in regards to the tracks that we hear? Are you producing? Are you writing your rhymes, his rhymes? What's the deal?
I come up with a lot of the material, and Puff is just the guy who got the vision. He got the overall vision, the worldwide vision. Like, I came up with the song, Can't Nobody Hold Me Down.
Right.
And he just took it to the next level with the video and everything. So I do my part, and he do his part.
Now, I remember hearing you on the radio at one point. You didn't seem to sound happy with the situation. I don't know if you felt like maybe you weren't getting your props or the right amount of money, or is that true or not? Was I just not hearing correctly?
No, I just felt like at one point, you know, that a lot of people wasn't taking me serious enough. I felt like I was the guy that came with a lot of contributes to everything.
Mm-hmm.
And that being that he was Puffy, that he would get all the credit. It wasn't nothing between me and him. It was just how the world was seeing it.
Right. And of course, the first thing out of everybody's mouth was, you should be happy. You were nothing before Puffy put you on, when in fact, you paid your dues and you've proven your hard work to him.
I paid my dues in a different kind of way, like staying in the studio from 5 in the afternoon to 5 in the morning every day, to staying in there from 5 to 5 in the morning for his album. 5 to 5 in the morning, trying to help Total with ideas,
okay.
Helping C's with ideas, helping everybody in the whole family with ideas.
See, Rap City, don't get it twisted, man. Mase got 10 jobs just like Puffy and everybody else.
No doubt.
He's worth every penny that you spend on the album. Harlem World is starts right there. So don't go nowhere, y'all. We'll be right back. We're going to find out what Cam is making, all right?
All right, Harlem World. Come on, y'all gonna be in the video.
I like when you were driving. I like when you drive the car. Ooh, big lens. Ooh.
You got the little girl swimming, y'all. The little ones, they couldn't be more than 7 or 8. Come on, before you get some more trouble. Speaking of trouble, you know how everybody is in New York. When you get buck wild, when you get out of control, your moms and your pop sends you down south.
Yeah.
For grandma or somebody to handle business.
Yeah.
So that's what happened to you though, right?
Yeah. So when I first started getting into a little bit of trouble in school, my mother always told me, you gotta go down south. You starting to speed. And I don't want to see you turn out like guys that you know or whatever.
Right.
So I went down south and I came back with a lot of good values, and I came back up here with the mind of a 30-year-old, but I was really like 15.
What part of down south?
Jacksonville, Florida.
Woo, country! Country!
Big feet, collard greens, lima beans,
okay.
Neck bones.
Yeah. Chitlins, all of that.
Yeah.
All of that.
All the stuff you never eat in New York.
Okay. Now, what do people treat you like now that you're back, now that you've blown up, you're this big star, you are the man.
Yeah.
You know, before you left, you came back, and now things have changed. Do you still have the same respect, the same love, or do you have people who are like faking moves now, who act like you're
the everybody
changed?
Basically in Harlem, they treat me like I'm the governor. People don't let nothing happen to me in Harlem. Like, I could walk this street every day, all day, and anything that happened, people would grab me and take me to the side like I'm the president. Like, they need me to do good to make sure everybody else in Harlem do their thing.
What's been the biggest change for you? I mean, outside of all the honeys up in your face, because you say it in a song, they doing things they wasn't checking about doing before.
Yeah.
But you know what I'm saying? What else has been the biggest adjustment for Mase?
All right, the biggest adjustment for Mase has been dealing with the people, like dealing with me as a superstar. Because I'm really into Mase and Betha, but you know, I got to live 2 characters.
Right, right.
A lot of times people can make the difference in their character. So therefore, they end up living a life that's really not them. So that's the biggest adjustment, just living your life and being you. Being Les and being Big Les.
Okay, really. People act like we just rolled up on the set. Ooh, party's going on here. We're going to shop for some shoes, y'all. We'll be back 125th Harlem World. Les and Les!
Double up, Harlem World. It's not a game. I just try to live up to the expectations.
Mm-hmm. Nervous though? Was it nervous in the studio?
Nah, I wasn't no nervous in the studio. I just wanted to do my thing, and I was just so anxious to be by myself without Puff Daddy.
Right.
I wanted to see how everybody was gonna react to me without Puff Daddy.
Okay, and everybody's been showing you nothing but love.
Yeah, no doubt.
Now the question of the hour is, say album two, album three doesn't blow up. Kinda just goes just say, what's plan B? What will you do instead of being in this industry?
Plan B is just, I'm making sure all my people get on, so somebody gonna blow. That's one plan. The other plan is just to open up businesses.
But you're prepared for all of that in case, just
yeah,
in
I
case.
Yeah, I don't wanna do music that long anyway.
Really? Why you say that?
I feel like I'm intelligent enough to do other things besides music.
So music's not here for you?
Music is in my heart, but music was a plan B. Music wasn't my first love and goal in life, so it wouldn't be my last goal in life.
Okay, he ain't mad at that. He'd hate to see you, you know, disappear from wax, but plan B is all right.
Yeah, plan B is the laundromat, the cleaners, the real estate.
There's this gym that I want to open. We're going to chat about plan B, right? Can't you just see jacuzzi, saunas, massages, little weight training, you know.
All right.
Boston out there doing their thing basketball-wise.
And your mama who came by to hang out with us. Bye, Mom.
Bye, Harlem World.
Bye, Sham God.
Bye,
peace
y'all.
Harlem World.
Let's go play some casino, y'all. I'm hooked.